Hello boys, how are you all? Hope all are doing good. Today, I'm going to take maths class for you. The lesson we are going to see is quick multiplication. So before I go with the lesson, I want to ask you some questions. Renu and her father have come to buy mangoes. There are 5 baskets of mangoes in a shop. They wanted to buy all the 5 baskets of mangoes. In each basket, there are 123 mangoes. Renu and her father wants to buy all the 5 baskets. So that the father asked Renu, Renu, tell me how many mangoes are there in all 5 baskets? Renu replied. She was thinking for a while. As soon as the father asked, she replied, Appa, there was 615 mangoes in all. So, you may be wondering how Renu replied very fast. So, what she would have used there? Yes, Renu used quick multiplication to solve the problem. So, today we are going to see about quick multiplication. So, already we have learnt many terms of multiplication in class 4. So, let's have a recap. First, we are going to see about parts of multiplication. First, tell me, what is multiplication? Multiplication is nothing but the product of 2 or more numbers is called multiplication. That is multiplying 2 or more than 2 numbers. First, we have parts of multiplication. That is, here 104 is called multiplicand. 104 is called multiplicand. What is multiplicand? The number to be multiplied is called multiplicand. Next, number 7. What is 7? 7 is multiplier. So, what is multiplier? The number by which we multiply is called multiplier. Next, 728. What is 728? 728 is a product. The answer, that is the answer we get is called product. Next, we are going to see about properties of multiplication. So, here we have 4 properties of multiplication. So, they are commutative property, associative property, multiplicative property of 1 and multiplicative property of 0. Let's have a brief explanation about the properties. First, commutative property. If you multiply 2 number, that is 9 into 7 is equal to 63. So, the order changes, but the answer will not change. The product will not change. That is called commutative property. 9 into 7 is equal to 63. Again, 7 into 9 is equal to 63. That is called commutative property. Next, we are going to see about associative property. What is associative property? Associative property is nothing but multiplying 2 or 3 numbers in different ways. So, here we have an example. 2 into 4 into 5. We are going to multiply 2 into 4 into 5 in different ways. So, that is, first, multiply 2 and 4. If you multiply 2 and 4, you will get 8. After multiplying the first digit, with that answer, you multiply the third digit. Third digit is 5. So, 8 into 5 is equal to 40. Again, the same number 2 into 4 into 5 can be multiplied in another way. That is, 2 you will put as it is, and the last 2 digits you will multiply. 4 into 5 is equal to 20. So if you multiply this both, you will get 40. If the order changes, but the product will be same. That is called associative property. Next, we are going to see about multiplicative property of 1. So example, 9 into 1 is equal to 9. A number multiplied by 1, you will get a same number. So one more example, 89 into 1 is equal to 89. At last, we are going to see about multiplicative property of 0. A number multiplied by 0, the product will be 0. So that is called multiplicative property. Example, 8 into 0 is equal to 0. A number multiplied by 0 is always 0. So 90 into 0 is equal to 0. 781 into 0, which is equal to 0. So these are the four properties of multiplication. If you are thorough with these four properties of multiplication, you can able to do multiplication quickly. Thank you, children. The remaining concepts we'll see in the next class.